Hi friends, welcome to Jillfish. Today let's see the remaining question paper, that is all important questions. 11th question. Patient has vitals, BP 120 by 66, pulse 88, SpO2 19 iron, respiratory rate 23. So this patient should be classified in which dry age it is. Option A red, option B yellow, option C green, option D black. So what is the dry age it is? Yeah, can you confirm it? Yeah, option C is a correct answer, green color dry age. Next question. The patient is having temperature 104, BP 140 by 90, respiratory rate 128 per minute, and the pain scale is 5. So which factor you will primarily manage in this patient? Option A, temperature 104. Option B, 140 by 90, respiratory rate 28 per minute, pain scale 5 it is. So what should be the main precaution you have to do for the patient it is? That is your option A, temperature, because it is a 104 degree Fahrenheit. So you must be concentrate on the temperature. Okay, fine it is. Okay, next question. According to ABC, which of the following describes improper cardiac circulation? Option A, hypotension. Option B, diminished pulse. Option C, tachypnea. Option D, CRT less than 3 seconds it is. So what is the correct answer? Can you guess it that? Yeah, when you are going to ABC, so what should do for the cardiac circulation? Diminished pulse. That means what is the correct answer? Yeah, option B is a correct answer. Okay, fine. Next question. Patient has temperature 103 Fahrenheit, heart rate is 110 and respiratory rate 23 per minute, and the BP is 132 by 66. Which factor you will primarily manage in this patient? The temperature is 103, heart rate is 110, respiratory rate is 23 and BP 132 per 66. So what could be the correct answer? Option A, temperature 103 is a correct answer. Why? Means if the temperature is going to reduce, automatically heart rate it is going to be reduced. So that is why you must be concentrate on the temperature. So whenever 1 degree temperature means 10 degree pulse is going to be increased. You know that it is. So that is why you must be reduce that temperature first it is. Okay, fine. Next question. During IV administration, which of the following drug causes extravasation and damage to the site it is? Option A, diazepam. Option B, epinephrine. Option C, phenytoin. Option D, ranitidine. So what is the correct answer? Can you guess it there? So which drug is going to be may cause extravasation, that is damaging? So what is the correct answer? Yeah, option C, phenytoin is a correct answer. Okay, fine. Next question. In a 3-year child, which of the following is the best complementary feed that can be given to the child it is? Okay, fine. So option A, mashed banana. Option B, dal rice. Option C, fruit juice. Option D, boiled soft carrot it is. Actually for this, all the things are related to feeding it is. But for the 3-year child, what should you have to give? For the dal rice, because fruit juice, boiled soft, this all the things we are going to give for the infant only. So what is the correct complementary food for the child it is, for the 3 years old, that is dal rice. Option B is a correct answer. Okay, next question. A child is on CPAP and is hemodynamically stable. Which of the following is the best method of feeding the child it is? Option A, breastfeeding. Option B, nasogastric feeding. Option C, cup feeding. Option D, IV fluids. Usually for breastfeeding is not possible, IV fluids is not a feeding it is. So what is the answer, correct answer? Yeah, that is nasogastric tube feeding, because baby is stable but not able to swallow. Okay, fine. So that means we are going to give a nasogastric tube feeding is a correct answer for the CPAP baby patients. Okay, fine. Next question. In a 4.5 mm ET tube, endotracheal tube, what size of suction catheter is used? You know that is 4.5 mm. Okay, fine. So option A, 10 French. Option B, 12 French. Option C, 15 French. Option D, 18 French. So what do you have to do for that? It is, what is the correct size for the catheter size for the ET tube? It is your option A, 10 French. It is a correct answer. Okay, next question. When declared COVID-19 a public health emergency on which date it is? Option A, 13-1-2020. Option B, 31-2020. Option C, 31-1-2020. Option D, 21-1-2020. Actually, January month, the COVID was started, it is. So, but after, what is that? The declaring is going to be on end of the January only. So, that is 31, option B, 31-2020 is a correct answer. Okay, fine. Next question. The trans illumination procedure is done with option A, vein puncture. Option B, angiography. Option C, bone marrow aspiration. Option D, blood culture. So usually trans illumination means just like a x-ray, we are like a lamination paper was there, no? So like that we are going to, you can look at the picture, come to know it. So that we are going to do it, use it. So for what condition it is? Yeah, option A, vein puncture is a correct answer. I think you have understand all the questions and answers. I think it will be useful for you. If you want more questions, you can contact me. Thank you for watching.